St. George for the MUT George Mountain Ultra Trail by UTMB this year. And I'm running the 100 kilometers tomorrow. I ran the 40K last year and it was a great run, but this is taking it to another level. And I'm feeling all right, pretty good. No, it's going to be a long day in the mountains. I did not finish my last run a month ago in the Drakensberg with stomach problems, so hopefully I can get it over the line. Quite a nice vibe in George. A lot of trail runners from Cape Town, quite a few internationals. It's good to see. It's been raining a lot the last day or two, and I believe the trails are quite muddy and sloppy. Not too excited about that, but you have to deal with the conditions as they are presented to you. All right, I think that's it for today. Pre-reg, I've done my gear check and number collection and all that. Pretty smooth, no problems. And see you at the start line.
Oh yes, and cue that music. Bring it up. Are you guys ready? Are you guys ready?
You are my favorite people in the world.
30 seconds. 30 seconds and you get to go tour with the beautiful Outeniqua Mountains. Have a tour, have a lot of fun, and Magetto will take you from here.
15 seconds to go. The greatest humans in the world, mountain runners, are going to do their thing. I'm going to count you in, ladies and gentlemen, at the greatest time ever. 5, 4, 3, 2,
Let's go, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, on their way. All right, the Outeniqua Mountains voices, the very first time.
Okay, here we go. Yep. Little muddy already. Yeah. Long day ahead. All right, update number one. We are 8.5 k's in, and an hour and 11 has elapsed, and we are just climbing. Climbing up Craddock, up to Craddock Peak. It's very sloppy and muddy, rocky, slippery, but progress is being made. I had a guy shadowing me for the last half an hour, but he's just moved along and I'm by myself. Pretty chilly. Looking forward to the sun coming up. All right, on we go. All right, update number two. We are 12 and a half k's in, almost 1 hour 40, and we crested at Craddock climb, then a long descent, little climb on the district road, and then we just had another long slippery descent. So muddy and tricky. Now I'm climbing again and went through a checkpoint, and apparently I'm in fourth place in the 100k, which is surprising to me. Anyway, there's so many runners, but I guess a lot of them are in the 60k. Anyway, not too concerned. I'm just doing my thing, which now is climbing. All right, here we go. All right, 14Ks, 2 hours, and look at that, first light, baby. Woo! On the ridge, going into this valley. Here we go. All right, 15Ks in. 2 hours, 18. And we've run into the back of the 25K race. And there are a lot of runners on the trail ahead of me. Anyway, I'm sure it'll be easy enough to get past. Here we go. Uphill again. Guys, then. It's gonna be a beautiful day. Hey, 24Ks done, 3 hours 19. We've had some nice runnable section in the last 5K, and I've managed okay. Wow, look at all this frost on the grass. How cold it's been overnight. Wow. Alright, 28Ks done. Looks like 4 hours 43. 3 hours 43, I don't know. 4:43 probably, I don't know. Through the forest, runnable sections. We've veered off, left the 25K runner, so I'm all by myself again. And my farmer's opened the gate for me. Morning. And I haven't seen anybody in my race for, I don't know, 2 hours since Craddock. So I'm just by myself. And if what that one marshal said was correct, I'm still in fourth place. Anyway, on we go. Three guys, look at this. Oh, beautiful. Okay, 32Ks done. Just gone through our aid station. Managed to sort my music out. The volume was turned down on my phone all the way. Anyway, it's done. And where I was running in fourth the whole way, I'm now suddenly in seventh or eighth. There are 300K runners just come past me altogether. And they're moving much better than me. I'm just gonna keep ticking it along. Really is a perfect day today for running. Wow. Wow. Take a look at that. Right, 40Ks done, 5.5 hours. Oh, we're in the mountains, high in the mountains. We've done a climb called Dizzy Height a little while ago, just super, super steep. But we've just had a very nice runnable section, kind of on a contour. It was very muddy and slippery though, but oh, I got some nice running in. Oh, just look here. Not feeling great, but I'm moving forward, so that's what I need to be doing the whole time. Here we go. All right, 42 k's done. Coming into the Tierkop aid station, where I've got my drop bag waiting for me. I'll change my shirt and a buff and heavier hat. Get some nutrition on board. I'm gonna take my time. A lot of 40k runners coming through here at the moment too. All right, still moving forward. Oh, that's gonna be a beer. All right, taking a few minutes here at the aid station. Nicholas also needing a few minutes. How are you feeling, boy?
Mug, mug. But I found my cup. All better.
There we go. Okay, gotta get up. Apparently a long downhill to follow. And in about, I don't know, 20 or 30 k's, we'll be back here again. Here we go. Right, 47 k's done. Out of that aid station. Long 5-6 k downhill. 3 miles and all, I guess, but smashes the quads. Gonna pay for that later, but I kind of took it carefully. In terms of position in the race, a whole bunch of people have come past me in the last few hours, I reckon, including Taryn, the leading lady, looking really strong. I reckon I'm about 10th, maybe 10th. The guys coming from behind definitely paced themselves better, even though I don't think I went out too hard. I just kept it smooth, but I'm definitely slowing down. Anyway, some pretty nice running now. Let's see what I can do. All right, look at that. K's up. Halfway, baby. Woohoo! Okay, every step we are closer to the finish than what we've done. Anyway, I think you know what I mean. I'm homeward bound. It's gonna be a long day still. I'm okay with it. The longer the day, the sweeter the beer. Trademark. All right, here we go. In the forest. 57 k's in the bag. I've been to an aid station just now at Dikkop. Very friendly people telling me I look great. They absolutely have to tell that to everyone. But I filled up my bottles and running, I think, on the other side of the dam now. Still pretty flat. Ooh, legs are getting sore. But I am moving forward, and that is my big goal for the day. Here we go. 59 k's on this dam wall now, and I think we've run completely around this entire dam. And as you can see, it's a pretty big dam. Done, and I've just seen the first runner since that Tierkop aid station at 42. French riders come running past me, looking very strong, and I'm just moving down the leaderboard. It's all good. Why? Because I'm moving forward. 67 k's done. Went through an aid station again about 3 or 4 k's ago, and filled up all my bottles, had a snack. Legs are very sore hiking up this hill. The next aid station is only back at Tierkop, where the drop bag is. That's almost 19 k's from the previous aid station. And this deep into the race, in my opinion, that's too far between aid. anyway, hopefully I make it. It's gonna be a slog. Okay, 69 Ks. We had a super, super steep, slippery descent down to the river. Very hard to not slip and fall. And then a river crossing where there was absolutely no way keeping your feet dry. Into the water, slipping on the rocks, ice cold water, wet feet, wet shoes, wet socks. And now we're up this super, super steep climb that's killing me. Oh my goodness. It's got to end sometime, right? So much mud. Woo! Almost 75k in. On our way to Tierkop. Oh, I'm thirsty. Hey, we're 82k's in. Oh my goodness, a lot has happened. So on the big uphill climb, another female runner came past me. Easy. She was so strong. Just ran away from me. Got a big gap, actually disappeared. Then, to my surprise, we crested and we actually had a started descending. First gradually and then super ridiculously steep down to the river. And before I knew it, I'd caught her on the downhill and then went past her. She was, I think her quads are a bit sore. And then I crossed the river just now and I've done probably the wildest thing I've ever had to do in a race. Climb up a slick, rocky section, then to grab onto a rope to basically pull myself up about 15 meters. So slippery, so steep. Oh my goodness, I'm spent. Oh, I can't believe that's in a race. Okay, I'm still moving forward. Tierkop has got to be close. Oh my goodness, it's like 10 or 15 minutes later and we are still climbing. It's so steep. 82 and a half can be, oh, this climb is so hard. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's go. Right, 83 and a half, finally at the top of that climb. Oh my God, hardest thing I've maybe ever done. I don't know, I mean, it was just ridiculous. I'm now on this contour, hopefully going to the hut soon. There's beautiful sunset vibes, but I wouldn't mind getting to that hut now. Oh, all right. Oh, that aid station finally came. I sat there for a while, had a cup of soup, changed my shirt, and had some drinks. Couldn't really eat anything, but I'm glad I got the soup down. Yeah, I just started not feeling great actually as I got there. It's, yeah, we hear sunset. It's beautiful. Downhill, my legs are very sore, I can't run it. Yeah, like 15k to go. Oh, can't wait to get to this finish. Here we go. Right, we're 86k in, we're on this traverse. So muddy, off camber. Oh, not easy. And it's getting dark. I think this is my last update in the light. I'll catch you at the finish. I just got to get there. All right, 98k's, and who would have thought I've made a bit of a comeback after that ridiculous mud. I descended and I've passed three people in our race, so I definitely should be back into the top 10. Come on, baby.
Who is it? Is it man, woman?
All right, there we go. 100 k's in the bag, baby.
It is man, and he is the running squad.
Alright, I'm in the finish straight here, the morning after, and I'm sore everywhere. I ran the last couple of k's downhill a little bit too hard and my legs are toast, but I did make up a position or two doing that, incredibly. What a day. One of the hardest runs I've ever done. That was my 700 k race. It was so hard. Lots and lots of climbing, steep climbing out of the river every time. And the mud. The mud, what can we say? It rained so much the preceding days. And even though the day before was nice and sunny, the mud, there was nowhere for it to go. And it was a slop fest. The last 15 Ks must have been the hardest, dirtiest, slippiest 15 Ks I've ever done in my life. People were falling over, we were pretty much all separated, but I was around a couple of people because I got passed after the last aid station by Kelly, the second female, and Mike Obery came past me like I was standing still on the hill, and off they went into the distance. And I was just trying to get through that mud, and I just did what I could, and with about six or seven to go, I started going downhill, I guess faster than them, and quickly caught up to both of them and passed them. Got through, passed another guy just before the river to climb out, and got up to the road and started bombing down the hill just after my last update as I was running. And I passed another guy, a French guy who was running in second earlier in the race, to the finish, and ended up in sixth position. But what a day. Very, very, very hard. Beautiful mountains, beautiful scenes, but the mud. Everyone that's done this race this year is going to talk about the mud. Anyway, that was George Mutt. 100k by UTMB is here, and I'll probably be back, but maybe for one of the shorter runs again to come and enjoy the weekend more. I don't know. Over and out.